I'm Sandy Graffius, your county controller, for one more month. I can't believe it. Okay, so what I'm going to do today is I am going to do a swan song show. So stay tuned because I'm going to go really fast through a whole bunch of stuff that happened in the last 20 years. I brought with me Ron Rutkowski, who is the only staff person left that was there when I started. So that tells you something. I drove him out. No, seriously. They left willingly. They either went to another department or they retired. So I've got to tell you, back in 2003, when I first decided to run, I didn't even know where the Republican office was to go get petitions to sign. So I brought with me a tape of a VHS tape of an advertisement I had made. And John in here at BCTV was just technical enough to take that old VHS tape, and I'm going to show you the 30-second spot that my daughter did, and she would probably kill me if she saw this because she was like 20, 30 pounds heavier than she is now. Okay, roll the tape.
When my dad died, my mom took over the family business. For the last 20 years, she successfully expanded our company, but also found time to be a great parent, giving so much back to our community in so many ways, while working with many different people. I'm proud to be her daughter, and I know Berks County will be proud to have her as our county controller.
You know, it really cracks me up. I don't look that much different from 2004, which shows what a good thing a plastic surgeon can do. Now then, back to running for office. I didn't even know where the Republican office was, so I found that out. Then I found out that you had to have 250 signatures in order to get on the ballot. Well, off to the hairdresser, off to the church choir, off to the doctor's offices. I had petitions everywhere because I need to get those 250 signatures. I ended up with 500, so I was able to get a lot of people sucked into my campaign. My granddaughter at that time was 8 years old, and I got little packets made that said Graffius for controller, and they were handy wipes. And I gave them to her to hand out at the polling place. And there was 8-year-old Chelsea with her natural curly hair, and she was saying, "Please vote for my Mimi." And she gave out these handy wipes. Well, I had gotten thousands of them. So the next time I ran, I had a stand at the Senior Expo. And I've got to tell you, the seniors, and which I am now one, the seniors are very sensitive to anything that's free. And so if you have a basket of candy sitting on your vendor table, they take the bag and they just scoop it up and put it in the bag. So I had people there that were handing out these handy wipes. And they'd say, "Here, this is for your lunch. After your lunch, you can wipe off your hands." And the one person that came over to me and she said, "Oh my gosh," she said, "I just had a question asked and I wasn't quite sure how to answer it." I said, "Well, what'd they ask you?" She said, "This gentleman came up to me and it said Graffius for controller." And I said, "Here." And he said, she said, "Before I could say, use this to wipe off your hands," he said to me, "Tell me she's handing out condoms." And I just started cracking up. Can you tell I'm losing my filter the closer I get to the end of my term?
But I have to add, with that story, every once in a while we'll have a little meeting and Sandy will still pull out one of these wipes to wipe her desk off after lunch.
20 years later, I still have handy wipes. I mean, I had so many thousands that I couldn't give enough away. One of the neat things I did was I got into parades, and I just loved the parades. I had an employee from the burial vault company who had built from scratch a 1936 Ford convertible. And that's what we used to go into the parades. Mm-hmm. We used Kenny's Ford convertible. And so I'd go over to the costume shop, and one year I was a Statue of Liberty, and I had this flashlight torch that I would hold up as I was running down the street, and I heard the mom and daddy say to the kids, "That's a Statue of Liberty." And the kids would say, "I thought that was in New York." And that she, that's just a controller that's dressed up. And one year I said to Kenny, the guy with the car, "I want to dress like Martha Washington, and I'm going to make you dress up like George Washington." And I wasn't even his boss anymore. And he was a good enough sport that he dressed up with the wig and all the rest of that stuff. Then I finally decided it was time to get my own car. And so I bought a 2001 Mustang convertible. And I still have it, and it's all parade miles, and a 2001 Mustang GTO has 21,000 miles on it, mm-hmm. all parade miles. And it's sitting in my garage as we speak.
I was asked once or twice, I think it was just once, that your regular driver couldn't make it. And Ron, will you drive me in the parade? And it was the, why am I missing?
Oh, the 4th of July. Oh, that's a big one.
I switch it into park and rev it up, and she says, don't you dare throw that in the drive, because there goes Sandy out the back.
Yeah, because we put the top down, and I'd sit up on the top. And mm-hmm. if they'd go real fast, I'd be like this, and they'd knock me off my perch. One time we were coming down Penn Street for a Christmas parade, and one of the girls from the department was driving me. And some little kid looked at me and with my blonde hair, and he said, are you Hillary Clinton? And I said, no. And Suzanne I thought she was going to fall out of the car, because Hillary Clinton is not my age. And so we went a little bit further, and the next kid said to me, are you Betty White? Once again, we almost lost Suzanne. One of the things that I did when I first came into office, they were dumb enough to give me a mass email list of all the department heads. And so I could go online and write a message and put in county department heads, and I could just send something out to everybody. And so I would write, dear department head buddies. Then one time I decided that it was time for the county to get credit cards. Now this was back in 2004. And I had a credit card for my company. And I had this little Graffius burial vault in Sinking Spring. So I send out this email. Dear department head buddies, who wants a credit card? They come back. I do. And I thought the IT director was going to have a heart attack. He said, you can't ask people that. I said, why not? It's time for the county to get this. Well, I must tell you that would have opened up the network to credit cards, and he did not have enough firewalls to take care of people coming in the network like that. And so I need to tell you that finally, a year and a half ago, the county got credit cards. Yay! I kept running until I finally achieved that goal. When Ron came in with me, it was in 2004, and he had worked for AT&T. Is that the right firm?
That's one of them.
Yeah, because they kept changing names. And he was in charge of the property. And so the first thing I did was I asked him to get all of the properties for the county appraised, because the insurance didn't cover the value of the county's buildings. And when I first came into office, I'm like, well, how can you do that? How do you know how much insurance we have and if it's covering everything? And they went, oh, we just kick it up 5% every year. I'm like, where did you start? What number is your start number? Oh, we don't know. That happened long before this. So poor Ron comes in. The first thing I had him do was get appraisers of all of the county buildings so that we would have a value that the county would be taking care of. The opportunities to help the county come into the 20th century were so wonderful that it really made us look good, because there were things that we were bringing out of business that was just a no-brainer.
Right.
And yet for government, it was all brand new. And it was really fun to watch the county polish its diamond ring.
Mm-hmm. On the technical side, it was a physical inventory.
Oh, thanks. See, I'm smart enough to hire people that know what I don't know, and then I just know who knows it. And then when it's time to answer questions, I just go, this is the extension you call, this is the extension you call, this is the extension you call. And if you hire smart people, it works out great.
It does.
Physical inventory, is that the word, huh? How about that?
It was a complete physical inventory.
When I first started, I've had many operations over the years when I was at the county. An ankle, two knees, two hips, you know, I'm so much titanium, it's not even funny. So I got a chair from Berksheim. I bought a chair from Berksheim that's electric, mm-hmm. like the homeless people use out in the street, and it has a little thing mm-hmm. that the more you turn it, the faster it goes, and the more you turn it the other way, the slower it goes.
That joystick that moves
yeah,
around.
Yeah. So a joystick. Thank you. And so I go tooting around the county in this chair whenever I had an operation, because Lord forbid I miss anything. So I'd come back to work with braces and bandages and all that stuff, and I'd have my little chair. Now, the problem was that I would come into the office, I'd use my crutches to get down to my car in the garage, I'd come into the office, and somebody from the office had to bring my chair in the elevator down to the garage to get me.
Not just anybody.
Oh, that's right. You want to tell what we did?
Not just anybody. So we had to go through training on the electric wheelchair, bringing it out of storage, onto the elevator, down to the first floor. Then there was a certificate that was created that you had to be certified in order to drive that wheelchair to get Sandy to work and back.
And one of the guys in the office was screwing around one day, and he went and got little cones and put them out in the lobby and made the people that were being certified run in and out of the cones with this wheelchair. And I'm going into the elevator, and if you lean front, it moved the foot pedal, and I got caught underneath the elevator that I couldn't get back off again. And the people in the elevator, I mean, I'd come home with that chair, and they'd split, because if I spun around, I could roll over their feet in no time. So the one time I had a wheelchair, and I had this wheelchair in there, and one of my operations, and we got stuck in the elevator. And it's, you know, when that happens in the movies, there's hotties on the elevator. Well, I looked around the elevator. There was not one hottie there. they were just not hot. And so I'm sitting down low, which means I could see in the wall like a speaker. And so it said, press 1 for red, press 2 for yellow. Mm-hmm. So I pressed 2, and it went bing, 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 nothing. Nobody answered me. I pressed the red, bzz, nothing. Nobody answered me. So I saw this button with this speaker, and I pressed that. And I get this voice coming out of the wall saying, 911, what's your emergency? I'm like, I'm stuck in the elevator. And they said, who is this? I said, this is your controller. They said, which elevator are you in? I said, the one that's not working. I didn't know. There's a bank of 4 elevators. I didn't know which one I was in. So she said, all right. She said, don't hang up, and I'll get you help. I'm like, hang up? I'm talking into the wall. And so the next thing I know, we're in between floors. The floor up above me, the doors are being pulled open by people in facilities. And I said, get me out of here. I'm a cripple. And they looked down and they said, oh, Graffius, it's you. If we would have known it's you, we wouldn't have hurried. And so the people in the elevator boosted me up onto the floor. And I turn around and look down. I go, could you please push my wheelchair up here, because I need that. So they did. And the next day on my desk was a note that said, the controller was stuck in the elevator, and the following people showed up in the lobby. 1 EMT, 1 fire engine, 1 hook and ladder, 1 police car. I said, if I would have known they were all down there, I would have gone down and made some new friends. I didn't know that we had this huge response to somebody calling 911. Right after that, a notice went up in every elevator. Do not use the telephone in the elevators if there's a problem. Crack me up. The notes soon, they sort of like curled, and they took them down after a while. But I didn't have to call 911 because I didn't get stuck again. No. Let's see what else we did here. Let's see. We had some interesting challenges in the beginning. The recorder of deeds was being naughty and absconding with some of the county funds. Mm-hmm. And so when the new recorder came in, Fred Sheeler and I, we worked together and got the case nailed down enough with the FBI mm-hmm. that the recorder of deeds spent time in jail and also lost her pension. And that was probably, for me, one of the most rewarding audit experiences that I had when I was in office. And you weren't in on that at that point. No. Ron is our audit manager, and we had an audit team. We spent over a year looking at deposits and looking at money that was in her bank, in her vault at work. And because Fred was familiar, Fred Schiller, who has just been reelected, which is very good, because he was able to read the programs in the Recorder of Deeds office, he helped me make a case against this former recorder, and we ended up sending her to jail. So don't be naughty or we'll get you. Now, some of the stuff that happened with the different staff people, do you want to tell about Groshna and the pumpkin?
So, the pumpkin per se, for the most part, decorations. We come up the most unique decorations. So we found a orange trash bag, basically, the type you put leaves in fall. You stuff them up real nice, and you put them in the corner. Maybe you put some decorations on them to make it look like a pumpkin. So we had one or two of these in the office, and Grosjean being fairly new.
Well, what did we stuff it with?
It was shredding. It was
paper
shredding.
Oh, that's right.
We shredded paper. We had the big shredder.
Yeah.
So we were able to mass enough that we're talking probably about a 4-foot diameter pumpkin, filled it up as full as we can.
What were those things? What were those old things that you used to buy that were like a big pillow and you could sit in? I forget what
bean bags.
Yeah,
the old bean chairs.
Yeah.
From years ago.
Yes.
So we thought we would recreate one of those.
Yes.
Put it in a corner, and says, "Go ahead, Grosna, try it." Well, much to our chagrin, when she sat on it, it exploded everywhere, shredding. Here, shredding there. There's Grosna with her feet hanging up saying, "Somebody get me up." I'm like, okay, so much for the decorations.
And how about the water bottle?
The water bottle, your normal 5-gallon water tub, and those things are heavy. And if you're around, you want to help somebody out, and a new one was exchanged that just wasn't set right. And the water decided to leak out, and like
yeah,
I said,
it wasn't
5 seated.
Gallon, it wasn't seated.
It wasn't in the machine.
Yeah, and it was on an angle, which meant upside down.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
So the water started leaking all over the floor and traveling, unstable floor, traveling downwards. Sandy comes over to see what the commotion was, and there's people throwing paper towels this way, paper towels this way,
paper towels. Big rolls of paper towels, they would just throw it, and then it would unroll.
How else do you, short of just turning a bottle backside to stop the water flow.
Oh, it was just, I loved it. I just loved it.
And this was soon after we had just gotten the new carpeting in as well.
Yes. Yes.
Like, oh boy, facilities are going to kill us.
Yeah, they brought in great big fans. They were They were trying to dry out the office. One of the things that we did was we had yearly conferences and seminars that we would go to because you have to keep updated on all the accounting laws. And Ron and I went to the Seven Springs, at which time we did
zip lining. Signed up for it right early in the process.
Yeah.
It was a great time. One of those adventure ones, you have to climb up the ropes.
And I wish you could
platforms.
Have seen me climbing up those ropes. It was like a rope.
It was phenomenal.
Ladder. And there I am with my knees and my hips and titanium.
2012.
It was dragging myself up this thing.
It was in 2012.
But and we did. We shone at those conferences and seminars because we always take lots of people.
That had to be close to when ziplining was just becoming a fad for the most part, and we're up there in our helmets and we're transitioning, but it was a fun time.
I'll tell you, every Monday morning I bring in baked goods because it makes people want to come to work on a Monday to see what kind of goodies are there. And we have a budget director who never answers his telephone or answers an email. However, he has a sweet tooth. And so I will write to him on a Monday morning and I'll say, there is key lime pie if you're interested. And then he'll come down for key lime pie. I go, while you're here, I want to talk to you about next year's budget for conference. And so, I mean, I just suck him in by bringing in the sweets and then I can grab him whenever I want to. We have Christmas breakfasts. We have Super Bowl parties. We have a big area back in the back of our office. It's like our party room. And facilities gives us tables and chairs. And everybody in our department's a really good cook, and so we get good meals going. Berks County, that's right. We got a new ORCO program, which is a financial package, in 2009. Mm-hmm. And one of the challenges that we had was that we had to load banking information into the program. What we didn't know was that it had to be, I'm not sure, but it had to be 11 segments of numbers, and we only used 9.
Routing numbers are nine digits.
See, and I just hire people that are smart.
And somehow we missed the leading digit.
Yes, we didn't put enough numbers in it, okay? So what happened was we did a total accounts payable run of, we do like 1,500 checks a week. Mm-hmm. And because the routing number wasn't right in the program, it got to the bank, and the bank sent it, instead of to Philadelphia's clearinghouse for the federal government, it went to Texas.
It was bouncing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It was bouncing around.
And so what we didn't know was that every check that we had written in that $1,500 group was going to bounce because right. There was no way for it to get to the right clearinghouse. So I got a couple calls, and it took, like it went on a Friday. It was like maybe yes. Tuesday or Wednesday until we found out. And I thought, oh, my gosh, everybody's check is going to bounce. Mm-hmm. So I start making calls to RAC because they had a check for like $487,000. And if they wanted to try to deposit that, it wasn't going to clear. So I call the newspaper. And we did another paper run, but I couldn't put that through our financial system or everything would have been on twice. So we had to do it in another test mode. But I had checks all over my conference table, mm-hmm. and I called the paper. I said, come up and take a picture of this, and I'll tell you what's going on. I had to get the check back from the people that they got so that they wouldn't cash it twice once it was corrected. I thought, this is the end of my political career. There must have been 200 jury checks for $9.76. And when the people saw it in the paper, they came in, they paid $5 to park to get another check for $9.76. And instead of them being annoyed, they're like, oh, you poor thing, this is such a headache for you. And it took us weeks until we got all the checks back, destroyed them, and got the people the new checks. Let's see, what didn't I do?
That actually led to one of your successes, one of our successes, and that's bringing in the card payments.
Yeah.
For the election and for other payments.
Yeah, we started debit cards 2 years ago, and yeah. it just has saved so many checks being cut. Our staff went from 28 to 19, and at one point our chief deputy went to another department because he was offered an opportunity to go serve somewhere else. And at that point, I didn't have a chief deputy, and it's very hard to find somebody with county experience that can come in and run your financial statement. So I asked one of the females in the department if she would move into that chief deputy position, and she said, no, I can't do that. If you do that, I'm going to quit. I'm like, So he left in January, and by April, every time there was a problem, I just push it over to Grajna. And so finally she came to me and she said, you're not going to hire somebody, are you? I said, I'm helpless. How can I hire? I don't know who to hire. She goes, I might as well take the job. I'm getting your phone calls anyway. I said, right. So, Grajna Nikki L. is our very first female chief deputy in the controller's office. And I'm so proud of that opportunity to give girls a chance to exceed in government. I think that's part of our responsibility. Now, where are we? Parades. I love parades. So, I'm retiring from controller, but there's two things that I love about being the controller, and one is my monthly TV show, and the other thing is being in parades. So I've made arrangements with BCTV to do a weekly show called Strictly for Seniors. It's going to be at 7:00 on a Sunday night, and I'm going to get anything that's cheap in Berks County, and that's what I'm going to push on the show. And just for fun, I want you to know that I have set up somebody to come in and teach belly dancing. So, you're going to see a bunch of old broads doing belly dancing, which is going to crack me up. And I also have an arrangement for somebody to teach oh, I only have 3 minutes left, for somebody to teach self-defense. So we're going to have self-defense. And I also have somebody that's going to come in and talk about the ghosts in the Berks County area. So we're going to do hobbies, we're going to do volunteer activities, we're going to do education that's available, and we're going to do planning for wills and financial planning and stuff like that. So each week it'll be a different, my watch is ringing, will be a different show. And then the next day, if you don't get BCTV, the next day it'll be on YouTube. So we'll go ahead mm-hmm. and continue to do it. I have like 1 minute left. So I want you to know that when you see Strictly for Seniors in the parades, I'm keeping my 2001 Mustang convertible, and I'm going to get signs that magnetically sit on the side of the doors that says Strictly for Seniors, Sunday night at 7 o'clock. We're also going to go around and hit all the senior centers. I got 4.5 by 4.5 cards made with the advertisement for it, because I figured little name cards, the seniors aren't going to see that. You know, they'd be there. So I got 4.5 by 4.5, and that will hand out at all the different senior centers. They tell me I have Sandyisms, and it's the beat goes on. Here's the deal. Are you new to the county? Don't guess, get Gus. And that's because when they say, well, I guess it's going to work, I tell them a story about an electrician that used to have a truck that said, don't guess, get Gus. And he wasn't as good as the other electricians. And so they would say, don't guess, get Gus, let Gus guess. And so when they tell me that they guess that that's the way it is, I just say, don't guess, mm-hmm. get Gus.
Yep.
And also, the last thing before I sign off, I asked them to dress to be remembered when we're going to be in public, which means a tie, a shirt, and a suit, and a jacket for a woman. That way, our professionalism shows when we're out in the community. Thank you for 20 years of serving you. I had a wonderful run. And Joe Rutterow is coming in, and he and I are working together for the transition, so it's going to be as seamless as possible. And Ron, thank you so much for coming along. This has been fun trying to tell everybody what went on in 20 years.
It's been a pleasure.
See ya.